फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज विदुषी एंड टुडे आई हैव ब्रॉट चैप्टर 4 ऑफ केमिस्ट्री. सो स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द एटम, व्हाट इज द एटम्स स्ट्रक्चर, व्हाट इज इनसाइड द एटम, लेट्स डिस्कस इन दिस चैप्टर. सो फर्स्टली वी विल डिस्कस व्हाट इज इनसाइड द एटम. देयर आर थ्री सब एटॉमिक पार्टिकल्स, दो दे आर इनसाइड द एटम, दैट्स व्हाई दे आर कॉल्ड एज सब एटॉमिक पार्टिकल्स. इनसाइड द एटम्स दे आर इवन स्मॉलर देन एन एटम. So there are three subatomic particles, electrons, protons and neutrons. Electrons are negatively charged, protons are positively charged and neutrons are neutral charged. You can also understand it by the first letter. Electrons have no charge, protons means P, P means positive and neutrons, N means negative, neutral charge. So this is the subatomic structure of an atom. Now let us discuss what are the charged particles in the matter. What are the charged particles means they have this charge, they are carrying some charge, so they are electrons. They just orbit around the shells in around the nucleus of an atom. That's why they are also called charged particles. One experiment is there. If you rub your hair with a comb and then put some particles of paper, then it will attract it. Why? Because the charged particles, which are electrons, are in the motion. So that's why they are just sticking up the paper pieces. So this is an experiment which you can do at your home also. Now let us discuss what is an electron. An electron is a substance, a subatomic particle, which is present inside the structure of an atom, which is a subatomic particle. And it is carrying negative charge. It is negatively charged particles and these are moving around the nucleus of a cell. So you can also understand it by when we just play a game of roundabout, when we go to it, just a circle. So that's why they are not moving in another shell. Their respective shells, within respective shells, they are moving inside then atom. So this was the electrons. So electrons were first discovered by J.J. Thomson. J.J. Thomson was a scientist who firstly discovered electrons, which were the charged particles, negatively charged particles which carry a negative charge. He was J.J. Thomson. This was a scientist who discovered electrons. He proposed that by the coming of 19th century, he discovered that atoms are containing some charge, at least single charge. So what is that charge? Let us discover. So the J.J. Thomson, who was a scientist, discovered that the atom is consisting charged particles and that are known as electrons. And they are negatively charged. So now let us discuss what is the structure of an atom. So before going to the structure of an atom, let us first discuss what are the protons and other subatomic particles. So let's discuss what are protons. Protons are the positively charged subatomic particles of an atom. So protons were firstly discovered by E. Goldstein, the scientist E. Goldstein. He was the scientist who discovered the protons before the discovery of an electron. So J.J. Thomson discovered it in 19th century and he discovered it in 1886. So it was earlier than J.J. Thomson. So protons were firstly discovered, then electrons were discovered further. So Goldstein discovered protons by using canal rays. He called them canal rays, and by the process of gas discharge, by the experiment, he find that there are some positively charged particles in a electron in an atom. So he called them as canal rays, and further he called as protons. So protons were firstly discovered by E. Goldstein he was the scientist who discovered that something is there which is equal to electrons, and protons are just opposite to electrons. They are negatively charged and protons are positively charged, so they are present in equal proportion. So that's why the electron, the whole atom is neutral in nature. The whole atom is neutral, means it has neither positive and nor negative charge. So the equal protons and equal electrons make an atom neutral, absolutely neutral. So now let us discuss what is an structure of an atom. So what is the structure of atom? How do you think these atoms are being made? So let us discuss what is the structure of atom. Many scientists came and give their own structure of atom, different structures of atom, because the microscope was not till invented at that time. So they just assumed that this must be the structure of an atom, because something reason they had given. So after all the scientists gave their own models of structure of atom. So we will later discuss it about it. So before going to the structure of an atom, let us firstly learn what is the symbols for electrons, protons and neutrons. So electrons are denoted by small e and this negative sign. So this means electron. Protons are represented by small p, and neutrons are represented by small n. So these are the three symbols for electrons, protons and neutrons. So these are the three subatomic particles which an atom consists of. Electrons are moving around the shell, and protons and neutrons are combined in the nucleus. They are combined together and form the mass, which is also called nucleus of an atom. So many of the children have doubt what is the difference between this cell and that biology shell. So they both are different, but both have the nucleus. So that is a different thing and this is a different thing. So we will later discuss what are the different models of structure of atom. So let us first learn what is the Bohr's model, what is the J.J. Thomson's model, because he gave firstly the structure of an atom. So let us discuss what is his model. Now let us discuss what is the Thomson's model of an atom. So before going to that, let's have a look on this structure. This was the model which Thomson gave, that an atom looked like just this. He suggested that atom is like a Christmas pudding, on which we can also understand by the help of the example of watermelon. We all knew that. So watermelon just have seeds inside it and red edible part. So it was just similar to this. So this is the positive sphere. This is the positive sphere, and electrons are embedded in it. Electrons are embedded on it. Means this is the red part which we can eat, and these are the seeds of a watermelon which represents electrons. So this was like a watermelon. So we can also understand it by the help of watermelon's example. So Thomson just suggested that the atoms looks like this, because there are electrons and the positive sphere, which is known as protons. So this was the Thomson's model of an atom, and he proposed that the atoms have the atoms have two electron positive one positive and one negative part. So electrons are embedded in it and positive sphere is all through it. Means everywhere this positive sphere is present and electrons are embedded in it. Just like some beads. These are like some beads and this whole sphere is positively charged. So this was the statement of Thomson, and many scientists came after Thomson and they could not find any of the similarities between this and the modern day atoms structure. So they are not satisfied with the Thomson's model of an atom. So they just drop it out. And now we will learn what is the next, that is Rutherford's model of an atom. So now discuss the structure of an atom, and in this part we will learn Rutherford's model of an atom. So let's have a look on this diagram. What it is showing, let's see. These are the gold atoms. Because he take the gold atoms because there is very thin foil of gold, just like aluminium foil we use in the kitchens. Such that he used the gold foil because it is very thin and the particles, the rays can pass through it. And he passed the alpha particles, which are also helium particles. So these particles just pass across the gold foil. And then he saw that some particles were just deflected, just like this. Some particles were deflected. And when he just observed, then he saw that they were deflected by the center of the gold foil. When the atom of the gold foil consists of nucleus and it was deflected by the nucleus. Every time nucleus was deflecting this ray, you can also see. So this was the conclusion that atoms have something inside their cell, between their atom as something inside, which is just deflecting the rays, such that he concluded that something is there inside the atoms. And thus it was the discovery of nucleus. And nucleus is composed of protons and neutrons. But these have unexpectedly different results, because every particles were just deflecting in the middle of the structure of an atom. So Rutherford concluded that it has different results. As a result, the alpha particles just passed down. Most of the alpha particles were just passed down. So he was not able to conclude what is the final result. But he observed some observations, which were most of the alpha particles just pass straight, just pass parallel to each other. So this means that the atoms have whole space between them, very much space between them, a gap between them, because all the particles were just passing out through it. So it has gap between particles. So next was something is inside the nucleus, because that's why the alpha particles were just deflected out. So this was the reason he concluded that something is there inside the structure of an atom, something is in the middle of the atom that is deflecting out the particles. So this conclusion was made. Then another conclusions were also made, but scientists proved that it is not right. Before that, the Mr. John Dalton was also there, and he also discovered the model of an atom. He also derived the cell, which means indivisible. But later it was discovered that cell is also divisible into three different groups. But cell cannot exist independently. The protons, electrons and neutrons cannot exist independently. That's why the smallest unit of this whole matter is called atom, an atom. That's why whole of the atom is can be divided into three, but it cannot be, these subatomic particles cannot exist independently. That is why the smallest unit is called an atom.